All of your graphic images that you want to publish on your websites should be in either the GIF file format or the JPEG file format. There are a lot of other graphic file formats out there, such as PNG and Photoshop, Illustrator, and others. But at the time of this recording, GIF and JPEG were the only two that really have wide browser support, so you'll want to stick with these two. Let me summarize here brief descriptions of both of these image file formats, so you can choose when you want to use a GIF image and when you want to use a JPEG image. In the early 90s, the original designers of the World Wide Web adopted the GIF file format because GIF images are small, provide interlacing and transparency, as well as animation capabilities that I'll describe here in a moment. Although GIF files can only be used for images with 256 or fewer colors, these are referred to, by the way, as 8-bit images. GIF files are still a favorite of web designers and enjoy full support in all browsers. GIF images use a lossless compression technology, which means that no information is lost when they are compressed. They use a technology that scans horizontally across a row of pixels, finding solid areas of color, and then abbreviating identical areas of pixels in the file, thereby saving file size. GIF images with repetitive fields of homogeneous color, such as cartoon-like graphics, will compress better than photographs or images with color gradients or 3D textures. One reason to use the GIF file format instead of the JPEG file format is if you need transparency. The GIF format allows you to use image editing software to select one color from the image to be transparent. In this case, notice that my gray here in the image is now transparent over here in the right-hand example. Normally, the color you select is a background color. In this example, again, I chose the gray background color to become transparent. Unfortunately, this transparent property is not selective. If you make a color transparent, then every pixel in the graphic that shares that same color will become invisible. This can sometimes have unexpected consequences when a color is used both in the background and in other places in the graphic. Another potential problem with GIF transparencies that I see all the time with student work are the ugly white halos produced on some anti-aliased graphics. Anti-aliasing visually smooths graphics by inserting intermediate pixel colors between the graphic and its background. When the background color is changed, these intermediate background colors show through, leaving a visible halo around the image, like I see here. Very ugly. In this case, this image was created against a white background, and then I put it into a website against a black background. And because I have a green color and an original white background, the graphics program created some intermediate gray pixels that now show up very ugly against that black background. So the key here is to plan ahead. If you're planning to use very light background colored pages on your websites, make sure you create your graphics against a light colored background. Another reason to choose the GIF file format is if you want to have a very basic and crude animation with your graphic. The GIF file format features a crude but widely supported frame animation. Sound, however, is not supported, and image color depths are limited again to 256 colors. Many graphics programs, such as Adobe Fireworks or Photoshop, can create animation sequences and then export them in the GIF format. There are also a variety of free or inexpensive programs that can edit and create animated GIF files. So to summarize, use the GIF file format for graphics with few colors, for line art, for graphics that contain a lot of text when you need transparency or if you need animation. Now, in contrast to the GIF graphics format, the JPEG graphics format was developed to achieve high levels of compression on photographic type images without visibly compromising image quality. JPEG is the best format for scanned photographs, images using textures, images with gradient color transitions, or any images that require more than 256 colors. The JPEG format, in contrast to the GIF format, supports millions of colors, 24-bit or 32-bit, and uses a sophisticated compression technique called discrete cosine transformation to produce a sliding scale of graphics compression. When you save a JPEG document in Photoshop or Adobe Fireworks, you have the option of specifying the quality of compression on a scale of 1 to 100. A value of 100 applies no compression, maintaining the current image quality. The more you compress the image, the more you degrade its image quality, but the smaller the graphic file will be and the faster it will load in a browser. A value of 1 on this scale achieves maximum compression, but also results in the greatest loss of image quality. JPEG images can typically be compressed as much as 100 to 1, meaning that the final graphic file is 100 times smaller than the original. JPEG files can achieve this type of compression because the JPEG algorithm, which is responsible for creating the files, discards unnecessary data as it compresses the image. The results are actually easier to see than explain. Here's an image that's about 12 times smaller than the original, but suffered very, very little degradation in image quality. Go ahead and open up your favorite graphics editor and try increasing the amount of JPEG compression and watch what happens to the image. As you get more and more compression, you get this blockiness and this kind of smearing and blurring of the image. That's why I don't recommend using JPEG on images that contain text, especially small text, because it kind of blurs the text and makes it very difficult to read. Now, this process of compressing your images and preparing them so they load as fast as possible and also look good is called image optimization. This is a very important skill in making your web pages look as good as they possibly can. So let me now move on to the next movie and review it in more detail, the skills and techniques you'll need to learn in order to get your images to look good, but also load very, very fast in the browsers.